Howdy folks, and welcome back. Let's play Dark Souls 2 Scholars of Her Sin, or Onion Quest 2 The Onioning, as the case may be. Where we last left off, I believe we had just thawed this place. It has been a while since I last recorded, notably, I would say 2 weeks, maybe three. It's been a while. Anyways, I didn't receive any comments about the Ultra Greatsword, so what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to try it for a little while, and if I like it, I'll keep with it, and if I don't, I won't. So we're obviously still just a little bit over encumbered, which is going to just equate to me trading out my gloves for something a little lighter. Maybe. Yeah, there we go. That is acceptable. Now, I'm not sure how long, I might not even use this thing for the entirety of this episode. Oh man, that clipping into my head. It's a good thing I'm looking at it from behind, because that would drive me nuts. Anyways, so expect some derping. We're probably going to be spending most of this episode finding things that were frozen that now are not. So what this basically is going to entail is probably me running through the entirety of this level again, looking for goodies. And you might also note that voice quality is a little bit different here. The reasoning behind that is in my quest for audio-related perfection, I am once again trying something a little different with my audio. I did some reading and I found a recommendation that you set your, well, I shouldn't say you set, you, at least with like the microphone that I've got, you want to adjust your microphone gain such that you're recording at about negative 12 decibels on the high end, and you're doing that to avoid peaking, which is where the audio gets funky sounding when I get really noisy, which I do on rare occasion. Aw, oh, yeah. I kind of like this thing. It doesn't honestly do as much damage to these guys as I would like, though. I'd like to be able to, okay, kill them in like 2 hits, but it's not quite there yet. Although, admittedly, the thing is not enchanted at all, so I'm sure it's only going to get better from here. Where are you going, friend? Hey! Yeah, definitely going to have to get used to the swing pattern of the thing. It's very much a vertical weapon. As opposed to the, well, nah, the Black Knight Greatsword was similar. Just gonna take some getting used to the timings and stuff. I mean, I can still kill him, but I don't know necessarily if it's, you know, we'll compare here. Come on. Yeah. I'm patient. Yeah, it's, well, no, it, I think does about the same damage as my plus five Black Knight Greatsword does. So it's gonna be, you know, once enchanted, a superior weapon. We've just gotta get it there. I just realized I actually have enough souls on me that were I so inclined, I could level. Oh, hey, right about you. I think another part of it is going to be finding the sweet spot on this thing, because I honestly don't know where it is. I forgot about her, too. Not too particularly worried about her, because she's got, you know, a dagger. Yeah. I don't suppose, oh yeah, that's not a door. I was gonna say, I don't suppose I can open that door now that I've thought stuff out. And as for protocol, since we're coming through here again, I gotta try. Come on. Oh, I botched the jump that time. I'm just terrible. All right, let's try this again. Oh yeah, that's a miss. Saw that one coming. No, no dogs, leave me alone. I think I might be in some trouble here. Ah, get out of there. Drink, just need a drink. I don't wanna use the shield because shields are coward's ovens. All right, what kind of attacks we get one-handed? Nope, still all overhead stuff, okay. When it seriously lock on the one time, I'm like, I better use the lock on. And it's like, no, nah, I'm gonna fail you. All right, so I know these things don't do enough damage to kill me if I'm at like, you know, 10% of my health. But man, come on. Like, what is that? You guys saw that. I don't get it. Whatever. Lock on's trying to murder me. It has failed. Yeah, I don't know. This thing, it's too slow, I think. I'm gonna have to get used to it. I'm gonna give it some time. I'm not gonna be just like, you know, oh, and, you know, I've played with it for 5 minutes here, and it's terrible, and I hate everything. Nah, I'll give it 10 or 15 minutes, and if I'm still not grokking it by then we'll switch. Seriously, it's just not gonna let me target this chick, even though she's gonna maim me as soon as I walk past, huh? Okay. But yeah, so there will be some audio differences. It shouldn't really be noticeable to you guys, ideally. The reason I'm doing this is basically so that I have to do less with regards to my audio culling, because I think it makes my dialogue sound a little... Oh, I don't know the term I would want to use. I want to say, like, stilted, maybe? I don't know. To me, it sounds unnatural. It might be less noticeable in games with, you know, running soundtracks and stuff. But it's something that I definitely notice in my Fallout Let's Play, where, you know, I'm talking and it's my pauses. They just sound weird to me. It might not sound weird to you guys, but I'm listening for it type thing. So I don't know. I'm gonna have to fuss with it and see how it sounds, and we'll go from there. As always, this is a learning experience. Let it never be said that I didn't learn... Let it never be said that I stopped learning new things about Let's Playing. Which is honestly one of the things I like about it, is that it seems like I'm constantly learning new things about it, and it's, kind of enjoyable. No. No. Okay, so we have a block, and... Really? I'm curious what that is. Is that a parry? No, we have a knockback attack. That is a redeeming factor. That's my L2 right there. That might be pretty useful. Yeah, I'm not too worried about him. It's the guy on the left. Is that... I'm gonna check here really quick. No, okay, I was gonna say, does it damage my sword's durability every time I use that, like, crazily? I do know this thing's breaking pretty quick, which is kind of worrisome, truth be told. And, oh, what are you doing, dude? What are you I don't even know what that was right there. He just decided he had to get an extra swing in there for some reason. For this corpse run, I am going to switch back to the Black Knight sword, simply because I don't want to die on the way there. But looking at my audio levels, like right now, compared to normal, I am definitely seeing less peaking. There's a little peaking, but that's kind of to be expected simply because of how I speak while I'm recording this. I generally don't yell, but I wouldn't say loudly, but I speak very, very clearly, mostly, and at what I would consider probably a little bit above my normal speaking volume, simply so that I have some wiggle room for, you know, tweaking it, because I actually... Normally, when I do audio editing, it used to be that I would bump my voice recording audio by 3 decibels, and that was audible. However, the last time I recently started fussing with my audio a little bit more, I had to bump it up to 6 because I was recording it at a lower volume. And now, I'm probably going to have to be bumping it up by about 12 decibels, and... The reasoning behind this is, because, I mean, you might be thinking, well, why don't you just record it at 12 decibels instead of quiet if you're just going to up the volume anyways? And the entire reason I'm recording it quietly is twofold. One, it culls background noise. So if I'm quiet like this, looking at my microphone audio levels, there is literally nothing being recorded. And that's how I want it to be. Because generally speaking, when I'm recording late at night, which is typically when I get my Dark Soul recording in like this, it's quiet. There is no background noise. I mean, there are occasionally planes and stuff, but that's only if I'm recording really late at night, which I'm not. And so basically what this means is that I'll be able to bump my volume up from, you know, where it is now to where I want it to be, and I won't have amplified background noise. There just simply won't be background noise. So ideally, this means I won't have to do my noise reduction audio culling anymore, which is really what I want to do. I want to not have to worry about that. And I know there's probably still going to be a little bit that I do, just to kind of like, I don't know, if I like say pick up my own breathing or something, I will want to cull that down, generally speaking. but it should really get rid of the majority of the need for audio editing, which is, well, I shouldn't say audio editing, noise reduction. Audio editing I'm going to have to do pretty much no matter what, because believe it or not, guys, sometimes I tell jokes and they fall flat and I remove them from my recordings. Or I tell jokes that are really off color and I'm like, ah, I probably don't want to put that on the internet. Not that I'm like telling horrible racist jokes or anything, but there are just some jokes that I don't think are necessarily appropriate to what I want on my channel. There are jokes that, you know, in mixed company I would have no problem telling, but they're not what I want to be representative of my Let's Playing style. Because, you know, I've seriously missed this item the entire time. Wow. Retainer staff. These guys, I bet, were frozen. I bet that's what that is. 18 intellect. Staff wielded by the retainers of the cathedral city. Long ago, the retainers attended the priestess, but with them gone, the retainers were left to wander frigid Eleum Loyce. Eleum Loyce, there we go. Without purpose. So it's a staff. And my intellect is what, like, probably 2 points low? Yeah, of course. Whatever. Yeah, those guys had to have been frozen there. It does kind of, I suppose, warrant mention that I should probably start paying a little bit closer attention, because if I recall correctly, I think there was some frozen stuff here, but it looks like it got melted down and there doesn't appear to be any goodies there, or I already looted them, which is probably more likely, although I do see a little alcove over in that direction, which has me all curious. Ah, these guys, their reach, at least for the ones with the swords, I expect the ones with spears to have reach on them, but the ones with the swords have surprisingly long reach to their attacks. Alright, it's your turn, bucko. Nope. Nope. Ah. Ah, you're dead. And you are next, my friend. See, I can do that too, jerk. But yeah, sometimes jokes fall flat. Sometimes I just go off on a tangent that I think is better off, you know, not even being mentioned, and so on. It's just, it honestly, I can think of 2 times in recent memory that I've ever had to actually edit commentary out. Generally speaking, I kind of stay pretty stream of consciousness here. I'm okay with that. It's what I've been doing basically since I started. And I think it's kind of signature to my style of Let's Play at this point that I just kind of gab about whatever happens to be on my mind at any given moment. So I'm never going to, I think, start really, you know, culling down vast swaths of what I'm speaking about. But there's some stuff that, you know, the internet just doesn't care about. And that's okay. Oh, does he know where I am? I'm hiding. My sword totally isn't sticking out here. Okay, there we go. Alright, now, let's see, this, yeah, alright, nothing over there. We've got this chick right here, and that guy up there, but I'm honestly not really at all worried about him. Okay. So we've got this fella here, who we can't backstab because of his shell. That's okay. Oh, I'm gonna eat it. Yeah. There we go. Is there anything back here? I think I already checked, and yeah, there's not. You got a little bit of a break between the buildings there, but nothing beyond that. Okay, now I know there's a bunch of them in there. Oh! Sneaky suckers. I didn't even see her. Where were you at? Where have all my spells? Oh, that's right, I think I removed all my spells like an episode or two ago because I never use them. One would think I'd have replaced them with something. Alright. We'll end up using spells once we get back into Drangleic content and all of the enemies aren't basically completely resistant to them. But for the time being, spell casting is kind of useless to me. So, that'll be something, don't give up, that'll be something to look forward to later. For now, though, like I said, we're gonna have to kind of rely a little bit more on my strong sword arm than anything else. Alright, are you guys gonna attack me? I don't remember. Alright, you don't, but there's guys in here. And I seem to recall this being a dead end, but I don't remember if that was just because it was frozen or not. Oh, damn it. Why did I even do that? I was frozen today. Oh, shit, I saw her. Oh, I saw her out of the corner of my eye, and I just didn't even react. Nope, nope. Off. Run, you stupid tit. Jesus. Ooh. Oh, that was closer than I would like to admit. Far closer than I'd like to admit. Oof. Only slightly worried there. There was... God, what is it? My fiance, I know I've mentioned this in the past, that she watches Northern Lion. I don't know if I've mentioned it in any of these videos, but she watches Northern Lion a lot, and he's a Binding of Isaac, and I guess a couple other game Let's Players. I'm not a huge fan, but occasionally, retainer short sword, occasionally he does stuff that's kind of, I think is kind of clever. Let's see what we got here. Short sword wielded by the retainers of the Garrison Ward. Long ago, the retainers attended the priestess, but with their disappearance, the retainers were left to wander frigid Eleum Loyce without purpose. So it's the exact same thing as the staff. Yeah, except it's a short sword instead of a staff. Okay. Anyways, and one of the things I just remember him saying offhandedly is, like, he, I think, was getting, like, the shit kicked out of him at some point in some game he was playing, and, like, he squeaked out a victory at the very end of it, and he's like, there was never a doubt in my mind, and just the way he said it kind of made me chuckle. There we go. Alright, so yeah, there was stuff up here. I thought I remember there being frozen goodies up here. I should probably really be checking these things for mimics, huh? What do we got? Divine Blessings. Okay, I think those are the full heals. I'll take that. Sorcerer's Twin Blade, really? I think I know what item that is. I think that's the one that everybody calls the Sorcerer's Wind Blade because it's overpowered. Soul Vessel, all right, so what is this thing? Twin Blade originating in Melfia, doubles as a catalyst for sorcery. Rare weapon used by very few warriors, owing to its dependence on honed skills with both staff and sword. Use sorcery with your strong attack. Alright, let's go ahead and check it out. I'm not going to be able to use it properly, I don't believe, here. Even two-handed, yeah. That's pretty sharp looking. Oh, I see, yeah, there's your sorcery in, which I can't do. That's your spinny dash attack. I think that's that attack that I was just doing there, the little spin attack, is why everybody thinks it's overpowered, because you can just kind of spam that, but I don't know. Anyways, what was I talking about? I don't remember. I know I was going on about audio, but I think I finished talking about that. Then I talked about Northern Lion, and I think I finished talking about that. Oh God. Oh no! You dick. I think he's got a Dark Souls 2 Let's Play 2, but I cannot attest to the quality thereof. Dude's got a pretty good stream of consciousness narrating style. I would say that if you like my narrating style, you would probably... I shouldn't say narrating style. If you like my commentary style, you would probably like his. Although, from what I've heard, he kind of falls into... Oh, what's the word I'm looking for? He falls into a pattern that I've noticed throughout his episodes. He makes a lot of... If you were, like, a 90s kid growing up, you will probably appreciate his channel because he tells a lot of jokes that people that grew up in the 90s would get. If you just go check him out if you're interested in Binding of Isaac Let's Plays. He does other stuff, but his channel's bread and butter, from what I understand, is Binding of Isaac, which, I mean, I've played a little bit. I'm not what I would call even remotely competent at the game, but hey, if you want to see somebody that's actually, I guess, halfway decent at it, go check him out. Okay. So I guess that was a random plug. I don't even know. Let's see, other Let's Players to check out. Let's go with... Well, I mean, I've got my sidebar that's full of the... Oh my god, I am just getting curb stomped by everything. I'm rusty or something. No, leave me alone. I need AoEs. AoEs! Wow, triple kill. Wait, that'd be a multi-kill. Never mind. Alright. Anyways, let's see other channels. I really don't follow too many YouTube channels. That's something that I've noticed. Being, I wouldn't say, like, incredibly active. Excuse me, damn. I've got that feeling like you've got a hiccup, but you don't hiccup, and it's driving me nuts. I've had it for probably the last 5 minutes. Anyways, I've noticed... okay, so we've been down there. That, yeah, that's the bonfire. We don't want to go that way, because I never came this way, actually. Oh. Master ahead left. Okay. You gonna... Yeah, alright, you're a dickbag. Weakness anywhere. So what's your stick? There's gotta be a reason that this dude is in here with a torch. I'm gonna poke around a little bit. I'm not gonna murder him immediately. Let's see here. Pointless. Try backstepping. Hey there, golem. Yeah. On your knees! Anyways, back to my original point. I apologize for getting quiet there. It's, you know, actually paying attention to what I'm doing. I've noticed being on the... Oh. That guy still follow me? No. I've noticed being on the Let's Play subreddit that a lot of people there follow a lot of Let's Players. And I don't. I actually only follow maybe... 8 and I think probably 6 of those 8, 7 now. Yeah, I would say probably about 6 of those 8. I'm trying to think of all old bell helm. I'm going off on a tangent. I need to not go off on a tangent. I don't follow too many Let's Players. A lot of other people do, and most of the ones that I follow are smaller Let's Players, and I actually have them on my sidebar of my channel for other people to find, because I actually find smaller Let's Players actually give better commentary than larger ones do. Generally speaking, in my experience, but that's because I think most of the large Let's Players that I have, like, randomly just bumped into are, like, really large Let's Players. Helm forged from an ancient bell appears to be a mere curiosity, but is in fact quite practical. The top of the helm provides significant defense. It's terrible! Why would anyone? I mean, it's... Why would you do that? When you have the onion helm available, no other helm matters. But anyways, when I say large Let's Players, I'm not talking about Let's Players with, like, alright, I'm killing this dude. I'm not talking about Let's Players with, like, you know... 20 or 30,000 subscribers. I'm talking like people with hundreds of thousands of subscribers. I find most of them kind of obnoxious. So I tend to stick to smaller ones. I think the largest Let's Player that I follow is actually, I want to say Kikoskia. He's this British fellow. And he has, I think, 40,000 subscribers. Somewhere thereabouts, 40, 45,000 subscribers. And most... See, I don't want to start going off on a tangent here about Let's Players because I think I will have a, I wouldn't say a colored opinion, but I would unfairly attribute things to them that wouldn't necessarily be fair. But my general experience with a lot of larger Let's Players is that they all have a very similar style, and it's just a style I don't like. All right, so Vitality, because I need that equip load. I want to see if I have any souls left. I will do that after this menu pops up. There we go. I don't like the loud, obnoxious Let's Player. It's just not something that I've ever been a fan of. I don't like face cams, and it's I feel they detract from gameplay, and that's why you will probably never see one in any of my videos unless I'm making fun of the fact that people use face cams. Were those? Yeah, those were full healing things that I found. So, like, I tend to avoid a lot of larger Let's Players because they'll do that. And I've actually noticed that a lot of smaller new Let's Players do that too, and it's just like, no guys, don't do that. Don't be like the big guys. The big guys are big, and by being like them, you're just kind of pigeonholing yourself into not growing at all. Alright, so what do we have here? Petrified, oh man, we've got so many petrified dragon bones, I don't even care. Plus 5! I'm totally gonna do things with that. Let's see, I don't suppose, no. Damn, I was hoping that the ability score modifiers on this would scale up if we improved it, but they don't.
I'll be around.
If you make it back. Yes, yes, yes. All right, so let's see how this thing Alright, I bet you this thing's gonna do some pretty impressive damage now. We're lucky, maybe I'll even be able to peak like 500 points of damage a swing. That'd be kinda satisfying. Okay, so we're at abandoned dwelling. Yes, because if I recall correctly, there was that room through this area up on the wall that had a bunch of frozen chests in it. I think a frozen mimic. So I'm gonna have to not forget about that. We're probably gonna go a little bit over in this episode if I'm gonna go for this room, but that's okay. Holy shit, that was I think like 2000 damage. It was like 1960 or something. Oh, you're in on this? Let's do it. 676 on an R2. 677 on an R1. I'm pleased. Oh my god, can I do that? Oh, why would I do that? I wonder if I can chain knock these guys down. I bet I could. And if I didn't know any better, I'd say it just blocked, like I did when I was doing my little spin up there. All right, the lock is actually, the way this thing swings is really weird. With most of my other weapons, if I have a lock on something and I'm moving in, like, say, this direction, and I swing, my character attacks the target. But if I'm using this thing and I'm facing this direction with a lock, I swing to the right. So it's different, and it's something I'm gonna have to get used to. But I think once I do, I'm probably gonna be able to wreck some. You do. I'm probably gonna be able to wreck some pretty serious face with this thing. I'm also tempted, not necessarily, well, I'm gonna have to look at the enchantments for this thing. I don't know if there are gonna be any that I'm gonna be able to do anything really crazy with. Because I think, yeah, I made this thing raw because it had really crappy scaling, I think. And this thing has S scaling with strength, which is the best scaling you can get. So, yeah, I don't think I'm gonna fuss with this one too much. Oh, dude, I'm so sorry. Oh, that's 1906 damage. That just makes me feel good in a way that probably shouldn't be. Uh-oh. Gotta finish this guy quick. Oh, yeah. This thing is definitely nastier now that I've actually gotten it enchanted. I'm actually kind of curious. Oh, I was gonna say, I walked into, seriously, dude? I walked into that one. I wonder if, I remember in, I can't remember if it was in Dark Souls. I know in Demon Souls, you could only enchant weapons to +5, but you could actually go higher than that, I think, at a certain smith. I'm sure the gamer Darius will correct me if I'm wrong on that. I wonder if there's the way to do that in this, because I know in this you can enchant, I think, some weapons up to +10. I just, don't you do it. You and your glitch spears. Yeah, I know what you're capable. Can I open this now? No. Shoop de whoop. See, that's what I gotta do. I gotta download a texture mod for my onion helmet that makes it into the shoop de whoop troll face. I probably hate myself a little bit too much for that. I'm not a huge memer. 1200 damage. God. Yeah, this thing is satisfying me now that it's actually, you know, buffed up a little bit. So I want to go in there, but before I do that, I'm gonna have to kill this guy so I don't have him. So I don't have him trolling me from the backside later. My God! I just can't get over how much damage this thing does. Okay, so what do we have in here? I know there's gonna be one guy in here. Alright, yeah, there's a mimic right there. You can see the latches on it, as I've shown you guys earlier. Brutality. Okay, so I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna loot all these, and I'm gonna hit that thing with a Loyce talisman, and we'll loot it, and then I'll probably call it an episode. Bonfire ascetic. And you wench! I enjoy backstabbing with this thing more than I probably should. Old Radiant Life Gems, 7 of them, that's actually pretty satisfying. Okay, and what do we have here? Titanite Slab, which is probably useful. Alright, Lloyd's Talisman, use. That's right, give me your goodies. Oh my god! It's the Onion Armor, the Katarina Armor. I'll keep an eye on that thing in the background because I don't trust it. Oh my god, and I can use it. The Onion Knight is realized. Oh man, the world was not ready for one as beautiful as the Onion Knight. Look at this. Ah, oh, this is great. That sword just like clips through my entire body. Be wary of mimicry, therefore try two-handing. Oh my god. Oh my god. I want to see how this compares. All right, yeah, it's nowhere near as good as Raimi's armor, which is what I'm actually, I think, going to main here. We will be fighting the boss with the onion armor because yeah. All right, so I'm going to call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I will catch you all next time when we will be continuing from here. Until then.